everyone. I hope you're doing well. I really hope so, because the times are testing and there's so much we're going through. So the hope is all we have. Today I want to talk about how you can make a career as a blogger. Now, to be very honest, if when I say blogging, someone might think, okay, this is a part-time thing or it's a hobby. It's an interesting thing, but is it for us? Is it not for us? So I'll cover a few aspects about the career as a blogger and touch upon how you can make a successful career as a blogger. To be very honest, if you were to look 10 years back or a decade ago, blogging was not really a career. It was a thing that some people used to do. It was an extension towards editors, writers who used to, you know, have a book, maybe used to write blogs or columns. That is all what blogging was about. But with the advent of technology and the growth of social media and digital marketing, blogging is the new career, is the new age of blogging. And to be very honest, with the time now we're going through and the time that will evolve post the COVID era, definitely blogging is going to pick up as a career. So what does blogging really mean? I would honestly say it's a medium of expression, and be it writing, photographs, there's so many different ways one can take care of blogs. For that matter, it's not just about, you know, writing those lengthy articles. It's more to that. It's how you interact or indulge your audience. The purpose should be that whatever you're doing makes a person think, it can be rhetorical, or makes them interact and get back to you or comment on your pictures. If you're looking at social media, so many bloggers don't even write at all. The purpose, what they're doing, is they're expressing what they think, what they believe in through the pictures, and their amazing work. They're digital creators who are bloggers as well and made it big by collaborating with the biggest of brands, biggest of organizations. It can be for I would say for-profit reasons, not-for-profit reasons, their NGOs, organizations. Everyone needs someone who's able to, you know, chart the vision they have, able to express that. You can be a photo blogger, travel blogger, digital creator, content creator. These are all different ways of blogging. What do you need to be a good blogger? You need to be sure about what you want to talk about. You need to have a proper theme. For instance, if I am a travel blogger, I need to know that, okay, I'd just be talking about traveling. But that's, again, a very generic space. So let's say I am only fond of beaches. So my entire pictures, my entire collection, whatever I write about, whatever, wherever I travel and whatever I do or whatever I want to collab, whichever organization to collaborate with, my purpose should be towards, you know, beach vacations or something like that, to promote one particular agenda. So there should be a central theme. If I'm talking about mental health awareness, my purpose is very straightforward. So I should be true to my cause. It's only when it resonates with the person. For example, today I'm talking about, you know, let's plan a trip to this country. And tomorrow I'm talking about these are the things you can do to be healthy and stay safe, which doesn't make sense. It needs to complement whatever you do. There has to be a parallel theme. There's so many bloggers who are successful out there who made it big just by the mode of expression. Creators, digital creators with the use of technology, they're doing so well. The videos are so interactive. They get thousands and millions of followers within no time, right? You just use different platforms. For blogging, the platform to start out with are Blogger, Tumblr, WordPress, such a convenient platform. Canva has made it so easy for everyone to, you know, create their own blogs, create their own posts. And would you believe this organization nobody knew about called Canva, based out of Australia, they have made it so, the entrepreneur made it to the second richest woman, if I'm correct, in Australia within no time, simply because she had a vision. Again, it comes down to what is your common purpose. And blogging is a very interesting career. You can always do something when you think you cannot. Even now, there's so many students who are like, you're stuck at home, you cannot do anything. You can always do something. It's just that you have to have the will to do something. If you were participating in debates at robotics, you can't do it now if you're a school kid. Why not write about, you know, what it takes to be a good person to excel in debates and dramatics and public speaking? You can write about it, and there's so many other students who can learn from you. Why should you be the one who's always learning from others? Why can't we give back? You are successful, you are educated, you know how to, you know, get around your way. You have acquired that knowledge. Why not share it with others? It's very rightly said, the only way we can learn and improve ourselves is by helping others to learn. That is the best way to revise or, I think, improve ourselves. So that's the best way. This is the time to look for options. If you wanted to volunteer or work for an NGO, you can't anymore. Write for them, reach out to them, ask for opportunities, blog for them. You want to reach, as you've seen already, you follow the Mindler blogs religiously. It can be about anything. You want to talk about careers, education, anything that's important to you. Please do that. We have so many causes that are so important right now. Raise your voice, talk about them. Make it a point to, you know, express yourselves in whatever way possible. We all need that. If there's any kind of information you need, always reach out to us at hello@mindler.com. We're always here to help. Even if you have an idea about a blog, please reach out to us. We might be able to help you out. Thank you so much. Have a good day.